I'm Real Generic Demon, and this is What's on the Tape, Volume 4. So this is the fourth time I've done it, at least. Right, so what we're going to try and do is we're going to try and load this ZX Spectrum tape. It came with a bunch of bulk games that I got not too long ago. We're going to try and load it, because I don't know what's on it. You can see sort of some writing there, if it'll focus. There is some writing on there. I can sort of work out the words atomic, but I can't work out anything else. Survival's there, definitely in the bottom corner there. It's definitely survival. So we're going to try and load it. We're going to see what happens. This is going to be fun because I've not tried loading this. On side B, I don't know what it is. It's a C60, by the way, so it's quite a big tape. On side B, we have GP Spider something. Oh, I don't know. I don't think we're going to have much luck anyway with this one. And the thing that amused me most is that written on the top, if I just turn it the right way, if you can see that, there we get the right angle, it says Warren. So this is clearly Warren's tape originally. So I'm going to probably have to start with side B, because it looks like I've rewound side B and it's massive and I can't be bothered to rewind it again. So yeah, we're going to give it a go. We're going to see if we can find anything on it. It's always a bit of a hit and miss, this, so I might have a cover tape as a backup that I've got with no names on it. So that's also fun if this doesn't work. So we've got that. We've also got a screwdriver, a trusty screwdriver, to adjust that head if there's any issues with the actual recording of the noise and the adjustments that are there. Because of course people record them on different things. Anyway, so without further ado, we'll give it a go. Okay, so we're ready to go. I'm going to go with the 48 game basic, because it tends to be a lot of these games are 48k from what I've discovered thus far. So we'll give it a good give it the old low dit dit, which everybody thinks is funny. I just didn't know how to say speech marks when I was 10, so it always became dit dit. Anyway, let's go for it. Tape is pressed. We're loading. Fingers crossed. We're on side B. As I said, I couldn't be bothered to rewind it. It's such a long tape. So we're on side B. We're recording now. Or not recording, sorry. We're playing now. It's ticking away. I don't know whether that's a good or a bad thing. I can't hear anything yet. Turn up the volume a little bit on my telly. Oh, hang on. Oh. That sounds like data. Let's rewind that. That sounds like data, doesn't it? That didn't sound like the usual sort of initial loader where it sort of starts the initial thing off the sort of and that initial thing didn't sound quite sound like that. Well, so let's run it again, see what happens. It's very exciting, isn't it? Okay, it's good because it's nice to try all these games and sort of see what's happening. In the background, my dog is barking away. No, that's definitely not a. That's not the. No, cause something's loading there. That's too far. There's too much. That's too much. Yeah, right. Okay, let's fast forward it then. We'll see if we can find the end of whatever that is. Well, that doesn't sound good. Let's fast forward it again. It's a Scotch tape, this. Is that re-record, not fade away? Is that what their logo, what their slogan was? I can't remember, to be honest with you. Right, we've got data there, but we've not actually got anything happening. Let's keep fast forwarding it. This one was the one that sort of said something. Right, come on. Sounds like middle of the game. Let's give it a quick rewind. Alright, okay, there we go. That ended there. Very abruptly. If we're lucky, we'll have what was his name? He's now on Radio 2 doing the same sort of thing. He used to do Top 40 on in the 80s. Oh, it's on the tip of my tongue and I can't remember. It's not Simon Mayo because he's something else, isn't he? That one just started abruptly there. Did you hear that?
Listen. Ready? Come on. Yeah, I've started halfway through the data, so we've nothing there. That's been overwritten. Yeah, it's overwritten data. This doesn't feel good. It was good to see this, the lines appearing on the screen, though. That just showed a strong recording, or loud recording. Okay, let's see what happens now. Okay. We're about a quarter of the way through the tape now. There's almost ticking going on in the background there, of the. I can hear that. It's not voice. Ah. So, hang on. No, that's data again. Ah, wheelie! Ah, great! Oh, is it going to work, though? Wheelie's a great game. This is one of those... It's one of these games that I never actually owned a copy. I was almost always copied, and that's, you know, it's pretty bad, really, considering it was a really good game. It was about a ghost rider. I mean, and that also kind of rang bells for me, in the sense of that it was to do with... Marvel, but it wasn't, because it was a Ghost Rider. And go on, peel screen. Yes, it's definitely Wheelie. Oh, brilliant! That's a brilliant game, right? Yeah. So you're Ghost Rider. There you are. You got a little motorcycle. And you had to kind of make your way through the levels, avoiding there was a level called, I think the first level's called like Bouncing Hedgehogs or something weird like that. But it's one of those really. It's a platform game with a motorcycle. I know it sounds utterly ridiculous, but you had to... So, for instance, he's jumping the bus there in the background. And you had to jump the buses with Wheelie. You had to fly over the top of these things, or your Ghost Rider, and get there. I'm not entirely sure what the ultimate aim of this was. I mean, I can't remember. I think you just had to make way through the level. So I'm sure there was something more to it. But it's funny, because he's got like a motocross bike down the bottom corner there, next to the Wheelie thing, left and right. And then he's got like this performance bike in the top one. It's... Excuse me, still my cold. But yeah, it was an odd game. So we didn't get much for the first sort of quarter of the tape. God, what a long way to go before we got something. But we actually do have something here, and I'm hoping this is going to load. I'm not going to stop the recording because, to be fair, I've yacked for the last minute and a half, so it's a good chance that this will load. Unlike, there was this thing that journalists often put, you know, about games in the 80s taking ages and ages to load. There was only a few games that took ages and ages to load. Most games took between sort of 2 or 3 minutes. It wasn't that long. On the Spectrum, that was. I mean, the Amstrad and the Commodore 64 were a lot different. They took a lot longer to load, but not by much. But I mean, with like a couple of minutes extra, 4 or 5 minutes maybe. But the Spectrum versions of things, quite quick actually, if I'm honest. I'm brutally honest, they were quite quick. I'm hoping this loads and we don't get an R-tape error at the end. The dreaded R-tape error. Did the 48K Spectrum have an R-tape error? I know it's on the 128, but did the Spectrum, did the 48K have one? Because I don't remember ever seeing it. I always saw that it was a D-control break thing would appear. Maybe I'm wrong, but that's what I certainly remember happening. Look at the hedgehogs. We've got hedgehogs. Rapid decline in the UK at the moment. If you the hedgehogs are losing because they can't wander around, apparently. We're all sealing up our gardens, and we're not leaving space for the hedgehogs to wander around, so the poor things are dying off. So, yeah, anyway, Wheelie, cracking game, brilliant thing, lot of fun, and it's taking a lot longer to load than I thought I had that would. That's typical, isn't it? It's the moment I start talking and yakking about it. But there's nothing better. So you're all sitting through the load. This is what we used to have to do in the 80s. We had to sit and load these games. And we'd sit and we'd watch and we'd watch and we'd watch and we'd watch and we'd wait and we'd wait and we'd wait. And then it would crash. Frequently. No, I don't remember. I actually don't remember my Spectrum crashing that often, if I'm honest. It probably did more than I would admit, but my memory's a bit foggy on the number of times that I actually had to reload a game, so... But there's nothing nicer than the sound of data being loaded. Oh, I'm delighted with this. This is a good find. Oh, what did I say? R-tape error. After all that, R-tape error. Oh, we're not going to try it again because this is what's on the tape. So we got Wheelie there. So we're going to fast forward on. I'm going to just do new on the screen and we'll just refresh that. And we'll put load in again. And we'll see what else is on here. Oh, I can't believe it. So that's the end of the Wheelie's date. I can't believe that. You know, I knew that was coming. I jinxed it the moment I said RSA Barrow, didn't I? Right, that's the end of that one. No, it's not. Okay, on we go. Right, okay, we're at the end of the tape again. Hopefully... Oh, we're at the end of the spacing. About halfway through the tape now. I can't believe that. I jinxed it, didn't I? I wanted to show you Wheelie as well. It's a cracking game. Who's played it that I know? Who's? I think 20th Century Gaming has played it on his channel. I don't know if he's still got it on there, though, but he was definitely a person who played Wheelie. What we got now? Flight. I wonder if this is Flight Simulator. Oh. Yeah, this might be the one. Is it Cyan? Who used to do these? Used to do these ones for the early games for the Spectrum. The ones kind of came in those, you know, branded ZX Spectrum Sinclair things. They were really nice, actually. Those branded tapes, I have to admit. I always quite liked them. I've got quite a selection, actually, of my own personal collection of those ones. I've definitely got Flight Simulator, Flight Simulation, if that's what it is. Not sure. We've been quite lucky on this tape. I mean, okay, we've had an R-tape error there, but we've been quite lucky. Yep, it is, it's Flight Simulation. Leave your tape running. I am. 1982. Yes, our data going in. The initial header with the sort of getting yourself set up with the necessary basic commands and then, you know, doing whatever else, and then we get the loading of the actual code, the machine code for the game. Psion? 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 Was it Psion? I don't know how you say it. I always think it was Psion, but it's probably not. Psion. Yeah, they were always economic with their loading screens, if you ask me. Because there you've got a picture of Saturn with its rings, I guess. And I don't know what the planet is, a moon floating around it, and that was their kind of logo went with it all. And then you'd have a teeny little bit, and it was always kind of in this sort of blue and white, and you know the cyan colour that came with the, you know, the sort of the defaults for the Spectrum. They were always, as I say, quite economic with the way that they looked. They weren't the most exciting, if I'm honest, of loading screens. I'm just watching. I'm listening. I'm not going to say the dreaded words. Fills me with dread. What might be happening? Oh. Oh, come on. Oh, it's very exciting. We've been, actually, you know, some of this has been one of the more successful ones. Last week's wasn't so successful. I say I had to resort to a cover tape as a filler. But this one's not so bad. I'm not complaining. We had a bit of bad stuff at the beginning of the tape there. There wasn't the best of bits and pieces. But this one we definitely you know, we had Wheelie there, and that's a classic. Shame it didn't load. Some of these tapes, though, I have to admit, when I get them from these bulk sort of purchases and people send them out, often not rewound, and they look they look like they've been stored badly. They've not been stored somewhere dry, and they've not been stored in any... Hey! Wow! Okay, I have no idea of the controls for this. So, should we do... Let's do in-flight. In-flight. Do you want the wind effects? Hell no. Okay. I'm going to go with Q8OP. No, that's not it. Ah, right, it's curse keys. That's it. I'm in flight. Do you know, were these any good? I'm not a flight simulator person, right? I'll admit that. I'm not a person who enjoyed flight simulators. But in the scale of things, were 8-bit computers capable of generating something that... Oh, God, I'm going the wrong way. Were they capable of generating something? I think that's my landing pad over there. Were they capable of generating anything that was worthy of anybody who did fly? And that's a very niche question, isn't it? How many pilots are watching my channel? If you're a pilot, please comment below. Yeah, I mean, it makes me wonder how many of these, how useful this is. I mean, what we've got there, we've got ILS, which I'm not entirely sure. I think it's a landing, isn't it? We've got knots, we've got speed, we've got altimeter, altimeter. I don't know how you say it. What's this, RPOC? I'm not sure what that is. Fuel power, range, bearing, gear up, and obviously gear down will be there somewhere. I bet you if I press G, it goes gear down. Oh, it does, yeah. That'll tear the bottom of the plane off at this speed. And you've got the flaps and things like that. But as I say, I mean, I wonder if you sat down as somebody who could fly a plane and went, well, actually, it's not too bad, really, considering for an 8-bit game. I don't know. Right, I don't know where I'm going here. I'm just kind of flying. It's not the most exciting of things. I'll tell you what, I'm going to smash into the ground. I know this is naughty, but I think we should smash into the ground and we'll try taking off, maybe? Let's see what takeoff's like, because as a flying bit, it's not the most fun. So what are we at now? Oh, we're dropping rapidly from 7,000 feet. We're going down. I'm assuming it's 7,000 feet. Yay, we're going down. We're going down. 4,000. The little thing spinning round. Whoa, look, ground. Do you see it? Something on the ground there. We're coming in. I'm crashing. We've crashed. It's kind of a crash like you would see in, what's it called? You crashed at a speed of 292 knots. How fast is that? Right, let's do takeoff. So I guess you just meant to fly around and land. Let's do takeoff. No wind effects. Alright, okay. How do I accelerate then? I'm trying to find some power now. P for power. Ah, cool. Right. Okay. We're taking off. Brace yourselves. I'm pulling back on the on the stick. The power is up. We've not got much. You see what I mean, though? I mean, how accurate could this possibly be, considering how bare it looks? I couldn't imagine myself playing this for any length of time. I mean, this is probably the longest anybody's, you know, my point of view. Planes veering around a bit. I'm taking off, though. Gear up. Gear is up. And we're in the air, I think. 100 feet or so. We're going for it, though. We're going up. I think that's just the height there, that 100... Or is that my speed, maybe? Let's get more power. Let's do it. That's it. We're kind of in the air. As I say, not very exciting, if I'm honest. I mean, I've played it for a few minutes now. And I think I've had my fill of it. So, yeah, Flight Simulator, well, that was on the tape. Not the most enjoyable of games, but it was there. So let's see what else is on this tape, if there is anything else. I'm quite looking forward to this, actually. That, from my point of view, you know, an R-tape error and a one loaded game is a full success. With no need for an additional tape. So let's push the reset now on the Spectrum, and you'll see my upscaler pop up on the screen. Yeah, I know most people don't like upscalers, but I don't mind it. It kind of sharpens up the image, if I'm honest. Right, basic again. Give it the old low dip dip. Oh, straight away. Manic Miner! Oh, yeah! I hope it loads. I always liked Manic Miner's loading screen because it was a... Hang on. I don't know this loading screen, I don't think. Is this a different version? I know he sold it to multiple people, didn't he? He sold it to Software Projects, and he sold it to Bug Bites as well. So maybe this is the Bug Bites edition. I certainly have the Software Projects version of this game. It's it had a really nice... Oh, I thought it always had a really nice... It really had a really nice screen. It kind of flashed between Manic Miner. It was one of those screens that wasn't static like you normally get with a loading screen. So it was quite... It was a little bit different that way. So... Okay. Manic Miner. Number one. Must be the Bug Bites edition, I can only imagine. You can hear it ticking away on the tape there as it rolls round. Yeah, it's good, this. And this is an amazing game. Manic Miner is just amazing. I played it on my channel before, but I have to admit it's one of my favourites. It's for me kind of the definition of a platform game. It's up there. It's there with Chucky Egg. And somebody asked recently on a Facebook group whether or not, well, you know, if you had to choose one or the other, I couldn't choose between Manic Miner and Chucky Egg. Manic Miner is different in the way it looks because it has lots of different colourful levels. Chucky Egg is kind of more flat and you know, but platformy, and it's very arcadey, and they're both are arcadey, and it's a really difficult one there. I couldn't choose. It would be difficult for me to choose between the two. If anything, Manic Miner would edge out Chucky Egg for the fact that it has these sort of different levels, the different looks of these levels, whereas Chucky Egg has it on the arcade style, but then again, it's kind of even, isn't it? So I don't know which. What a hard question this is. Yeah, I don't think I can answer it. It's not possible. If you can answer it, please put it in the comments below. You know, please say, yeah, whether you were a Manic Miner or a Tricky Egg person, or whether you couldn't choose. I mean, I bet you most people can't choose, because they're both iconic games, both iconic platformers. A bit like Jet Set Willy. But Jet Set Willy's different, because it's not like one screen at a time, so you can't compare it. It's not like for like, if that makes sense. Now, if this is the Bug Bites edition of this, does it have Bug Bites style? Because what Matt Smith did I call him Matt Smith there, as if I know him. I don't personally know him. But anyway, Matt Smith. What Matt Smith did... Wow, it is. Is he changed some of the graphics, especially in things like... what was it? Jet Set Willy. Anyway, let's play. So we play Minor Willy. This is before he got rich and became Jet Set Willy. Oh, it is. Brilliant. You can't really beat this one. It looks so good. So the idea is to collect up all the flashing items. And then... you go over the top of here. Collect them all and then make it out of it. There's 20 caverns in total. Now, I've seen it finished in less than 20 minutes, this game. And then we go like that. Wow. I can actually finish the first level without any grief. Right, we'll jump over this fella. And down we go. And off we run. Back to the thing at the bottom there. And that's all there was to it. And it's brilliant. It looks really nice. got the do. Is this different music for the Jet Set Willy? For the Jet Set Willy game, sorry. Is this the same music that Jet Set Willy had? I don't know. So the floor's that platform there makes you move across the other way. I do like this game. And you've got a limited air supply, so you've got to kind of get out. I think that the story is this: basically the caverns collapsed while he was on his seeking his fortune. So I always kind of like doing it this way, because you can wait for it to drop, but if you do that, technically you'd fall to your death, but because you fall into the exit, you get out faster. And you're going to see the limit of my abilities. I'm very good at the first four levels, I think it is, and then after that, I'm rubbish. Eugene's Lair is one of the ones that I find very difficult. See, this is where we go back to the Chucky Egg debate that I was having with you before. Chucky Egg is only like purple, green, and you know, and sort of yellows for the creatures. Whereas this Manic Miner really goes with the palette, and you rarely see any kind of colour clash in any way, shape, or form. It looks really, really nice. Here we go, the iridium, abandoned iridium works. Or radium, radium? Radium, either way. Yeah, you rarely see. Oh no! Oh, I've got to go over here this way, that's what I meant to do. You rarely see colour clash on this one. It's a really nice an example of sugar. You get to start all over again when you make a mistake. Oh, I do like this game. No. Yeah. Okay, so we go up here. We go up here. We go up here. And drop down here. We jump over here. I like the fact that there's a maze factor to it. You have to work out your way across the level to get there. That's it. And then we go up here like this, like that. Now, how do I get into there? I can't remember. Damn it, fell too far. Can't remember. As I said to you before, it's testing the limits of my knowledge of this one. It's been a while since I played it, actually. It's a really good game. I have the software project version of it. I also have a t-shirt with this on, actually. Very nice t-shirt. A little Manic Miner walking around. Alright, okay, here we go. Can't believe I just did that. What an idiot. Well, that was brilliant. That was a good find, wasn't it? That was excellent. Right, okay. On we go. Forward and upward and whatever else it is. Something or other. This could be a very long episode. Brace yourselves. Get a cup of tea. I may take an ad break shortly. No, I'm kidding. Right, okay. Let's do it again. Right, so Upscaler pops up on the screen. Hello, Upscaler. There we go.
That's straight to data, that. That was after...
There, see, the Manic Miner ended, and we go straight to data, right? Okay, we'll fast forward through that, we'll see if we can find anything. I remember these tapes, though. There was people with masses of things, you know, stored on games. Oh, hang on, we've got something. Under. Oh, is this Underworld? Are we doing everyone? The greatest hits of Spectrum games? Possibly. Doo-loo-loo. That sounds like it is.
However, I can hear a lot of background noise now.
No, I think this is good.
A lot of background grrring now and grrring, grinding.
I'm surprised. I'd like to say hello to my dog that's spending a lot of time in this episode. If you haven't heard it in the background, it's been barking away. It is about, I don't know, tail to nose to tail is about 35 centimetres long. Yeah, I knew that wasn't good. You can hear it on the tape there. That was going to be a bad one. But that would have been Underworld. That would have been Underworld. Let's keep forwarding and see what else we can find on here. Yeah, that doesn't sound good, though. I'm forwarding a little bit here. We'll just put the load on there. Yeah, it's there in the background. The horrible dog. No, it's 35 centimetres long, and it's a cross between a Chihuahua and a Yorkshire Terrier, and it thinks it's a Rottweiler. Apart from when you open the door and it sees whatever's coming at it, then it cowers and hides. So it's fine behind the glass. It's like an internet troll. It can shout from behind the keyboard, but can't actually say it to your face, kind of thing. Anyway, right, okay, here we go. Bites X. Right, we're gonna go back a little bit. Back a little bit there. No, right, okay. Bit further. I think that could be part of the game. Joust! Ah, right, excellent.
Ah.
Bites joust. Do we... Okay, back a bit, maybe. Yeah, I've got there again. Let's go a little bit further. Let's see if we can do it from here, see if a gun goes for it. If it does bites joust again, I'm going to try doing load code and we'll see if we can get it to go on. Yeah.
Okay, we're going to do a load code.
Right, okay, so we'll just break out here and we'll do load code. It's worth a try. This will be interesting to see if it starts. As I say, there was a debate raging last time about how that was possible that it could actually load. So we'll give it a try, see what happens. Or how it would actually start once it initiated. I don't think we came to a consensus on that, to be honest, on what was possibly happening with it, but it was worth a try. Okay. Not sure how well these are going to work. They're kind of looking a bit... The lines on the side of the screen should be steady and stable. That was what it was always said. I actually said that in the manual. I'm quite convinced it did. And you should have nice, steady, stable lines on the edge of the screen. Now, we might get a screenshot here, but I'm not 100% sure. I played Joust recently, the original arcade version, or one of the versions. They have kind of names like green, white, and red, white, and whatever else it is. Softec, Joust. Brilliant. Okay. I'm actually quite looking forward to seeing this here if it does load. I'm hoping it loads. Because it's quite an interesting game. You have to hit the other riders from above on your sort of ostrich bird thing. So you're the one that's yellow and the blue one there, and they're the red and the green. And you have to hit them from above, which knocks them off their mounts. And then you have to collect the eggs that fly that they come from them. I know it sounds really weird, but you collect the eggs and that's them destroyed, and you just have to clear the level as fast as possible. The only thing that isn't killable is there's a is it pterodactyl? Pterodactyl? I can't remember. One of the two. One isn't real. But either way, one of those flies across, and that's the only thing that isn't killable. But the idea is just to knock them off their mounts. Now, if they hit you from above, then you lose. If you hit each other bang on the centre, it's a draw, if that kind of makes sense. You bounce off each other. So, oh wow, it's loaded again. Keys, bottom keys for instructions, bottom keys. Joust. I've got to hold the button down. Hidden in the folds of time, time's cloak, there lies a tale of shadowy lords. Oh, right, okay. So this is our story. To go left, keys on the left to go left, bottom rope to fly. Left keys to go left, right keys to go right, and bottom keys to do that. Highest lance wins, there you go. So, bottom key, Yeah, I've got them left and right. Oh, cool. Oh, do you know what? It's a bit of a shame they didn't do the, what was in the loading there, where they were the colours, because that was the colours from the arcade game. So highest lance wins. Yeah, got him. Oh, it's a little bit. It's a little less. It's got the same levels. It's just a little less. It's just a little less. A very the computer's very tough. Yeah. So highest lance. Ah! Highest lance wins. I'd like to finish a level. It's not bad. It's probably a little easy, actually, in comparison to the arcade. And I say that very sort of, you know, sort of, you know, the arcade is very tough. And I know I haven't finished this level yet, but there's some. Damn it! He keeps winning on the sort of draw level there. You have a high score. Demon. Yeah. I like this. Pressing a key. I'm going to try again. I'll see if I can finish this. First, finish the level. Ah, damn. Flew across and got killed. The water kills you, but it's a fire on the actual arcade version. On the it's an Atari game? Can't remember. It's not bad, actually. It's not bad at all. Right, I have a bit of a problem with the AI on this, because you're always going to lose to the one at the top there, if that makes sense. You have to drag him down a bit to make him come after you to get him to do that. Buzzard bait, that's what it's called, this level. There's one. Ah, he's got me again, because he's right at the top, and he literally matches my level. Oh no, because I ran up level with him effectively to run into him. Oh. Oh, I didn't even get a high score there. A nightmare. Right, push key. Here we go. Yeah, I quite like this. It's not bad. And we did it with load code again. Just to confuse everybody. Don't know how we did that with load code, but we did do it with load code again. Right, you can kind of make them wave downwards. Yes! Finished the level! I don't know if you get the bonuses that you get with the other games. Wave one. Ooh, he's a new guy in green. Maybe he takes two hits to do. Possibly. Oh, it's not bad. There's some good interesting stuff on this tape. When I was a kid, we would absolutely jam. You get like a, you wouldn't just be a C60, it'd be like a C90. You'd absolutely jam it with games, and then you had no idea. And then you'd have that rudimentary list of on the front of it of what was on it and where you had to fast forward to with your tape player, because everybody's tape player was slightly different where it came to the counter that went round, and the counter was sort of there to kind of count how far the tape had run. It wasn't timed by, I don't think it was timed by minutes or anything like that. I think it was more rudimentary. I think it just rolled round. I don't think you could say 3 minutes in it was going to be this game. I don't think that's how it worked particularly. I remember them having like 492 and stuff like that on the written on the tape, and it would just be ridiculous, really. That's cool. Joust. Not bad. Right, let's reset this and see what else we can find. There's got to be more on here. I can feel it. Okay, let's reset the PC. Oh, the PC. The Spectrum. Right, let's go for the loading. There was a noise there. It wasn't a very good noise. Right, we are near the end of the tape now. Actually near the end of side B. We'll go to side A in a minute. I know, just to confuse everybody. This has been 100% successful. A very long video, but well worth it. Promise you. You've enjoyed the experience at the same time as me. Nothing there thus far. I can hear a noise, but I don't think it's anything. And if it is data, it's far too quiet for the tape player to hear. No, I think that's it. Right, we're flipping over. We're on side A. Let's have a little go and see what we find.
Let's go for it. You might have to have another. You might have to have another 45 minutes of me chatting away to you.
Let's see.
So I've been a very successful team. Oh, ghost.
Ghost what?
Busters.
Ghost Hunter.
Can't think of any ghost games now off the top of my head. Oh, Fast Loader. Okay. Oh, there's the screen being... No! No!
That one didn't work. Let's give it a rewind. Should we give it another try? Because it looked good. Let's give it another try.
Let's try with... I was just thinking here. What am I doing?
I'm thinking
that we should just give it another try, actually. I was thinking about something else there, but I can't remember what it was.
Do you know how my brain doesn't work sometimes?
I blame it on old age. I was much better when the Spectrum was around. Right, okay, what we got now? Give this ghost one again. If it doesn't load after this, we're going to fast forward. The fast loaders are notoriously bad. I can't think of a ghost game that it could possibly be, though. Doodle-loot. Ah, there's a doodle-loot there. Is that a classic ultimate doodle-loo-doo? Could be, you know. What games by Ultimate were called?
Not having it.
Right, okay, we're going to try again. We'll speed on and we'll see what else is on the tape.
So,
no, fast forwarding on.
Okay, on we go. Oh,
I fast forwarded perfectly to a space.
I don't hear anything. It's very quiet. I'm just going to turn up the telly. No, I couldn't, but I've just turned it down, and there we go.
Oh, lovely lines on that one. Amfoot. Amfoot? No idea. Never heard of it. The thing about this as well is you also find the games that other people liked, you know, the ones that they actively sought to copy, the ones that they sort of thought, you know, yeah, that's so good that I really want to copy it. And that's the most interesting thing. I have a game that was on a friend's, he lent me a compilation that he didn't make it, somebody else made it, gave it to him, he loaned it to me to try, and there was a game on it, and because it had been sort of dubbed several times, I couldn't make a copy of it, I'm afraid, but there was a game on it, and it had like a little character with a smiley face, and he ran around, oh, American football, alright, that makes sense, he had a little smiley face, and it ran around, and I think it collected things in sort of rooms. It was a maze type game, but I think there was a school element to it. And do you know what? To this day, I can't remember what it was called, and I cannot find it. And there are so many ZX Spectrum games, and they're still being produced that I don't think I'm ever going to find it. One of these days, I'm going to load up one of these tapes and go, ah, that's the one. That's the game. I remember it, but I can't remember anything else. American football. Angus Press Software, 1984. Don't know how well this is going to work. Sometimes you got them where they went the full hog, and you know they created a gigantic sprite, and you stood behind the player or whatever else it was. I guess as a management thing, it probably wouldn't be too bad. I don't know. Quite looking forward to this game, then. I'm very much looking forward to it, if I'm honest. Running nicely now. Was one of the games on the a Mega Drive that was one of my favourites was Cyberball, which was basically American football but with robots, and I quite liked that one because you kind of chose your plays. Your interaction was kind of minimal, but funnily enough, it worked quite well. It was one of those kind of games that I quite liked, to be honest with you. Really quite enjoyed that one.
Sounds of Spectrum. It's the name of my carpet, actually. It's a Sound of Spectrum. Kind of looks like it a little bit. Looks like that sort of that data fuzzing around on it, to be honest with you, with a little bit flex in it, so it's quite fun. I hope this doesn't take too long to load. Brace yourselves. Fast forward if you feel the need. I'm not in a position to do so. I would stop and start again, but to be honest with you, as I say, most of these haven't taken that long to load. So, I wonder what else we've got on here. Now, interesting enough, looking through the cover now, or onto the cassette as it's loading, I can definitely see Am Football, and I can see at least two other games, one of which being Survival, which is a kind of weird game. I've got, and to be fair, it's if you ever buy bulk Spectrum games like I do, off things like eBay and other places, what you find is that amongst that, almost always, there's about 10 copies of Survival. It seems like everybody had it. Had a sort of a hawk or an eagle, wasn't it? Eagle, must get it right. An eagle sort of dashing down to eat a small mouse, and the idea was you have to survive as an animal. So you was got an early survival game. Actually, thinking about it, never really thought about that. But you basically would chose to be an insect, an eagle, a lion, or some other things. And the idea was you flew around as the eagle or whatever you chose to be, or fly. And you flew around and you would collect up food or water to stay alive, and that was it. And the aim of the game was just to stay alive as long as possible. It truly was one of those early survival games, and it really was about that. And the idea was to sort of point out that, you know, that life is tough, I guess, as a I guess that's what they were trying to point out. Life's tough, you must survive by eating and drinking, you know. They didn't go so far as to say breeding for the next species, you know, the next animal. But do you want instructions? 10-year-old me would go no, but 40-plus of you and me will go yes. You can even print it out. Your role is a team coach. Oh, you just have to team coach. Oh, well, that's all right. That makes sense. Okay. Those are the things you've got to do. Those are the commands. I'm not going to do anything else with that. Player versus Spectrum 1. Yeah. So we're going to team coach it. You may name both your teams. So let's go with generic. Can't spell. We'll delete that. Generic. And your team is called Demon. There we go. Good idea, isn't it? So we'll do that. Okay, it's loading. We'll toss a coin. I want heads. Chooses heads. It's tails. Wins and will receive. Oh, okay. On the ball. Kick off. So, not sure what's happening. I guess I get to push buttons to make things happen. Received at 10 yard. Okay. Oh, I've got to push in your defence. Ah, right. This is where I had to push buttons. Illegal play. I don't know. You got to press buttons. Right, well, that's because I didn't... That's why you had to print it out. The instructions are basically you have to choose what defence you use against whatever they're thinking about. So there was a couple of things. I can't remember. Was it O-N was one of them? No. P? D-D for defence. Double defence. My American football's knowledge rubbish, isn't it? Alright, so it loaded. We've got American football. You play as the management side of it. Actually, it doesn't look too bad. I think I would have to write down the instructions for it, though, to really enjoy that. As I say, 10-year-old me would have been sitting standing near going, well, this is rubbish, isn't it? But 40-year-old plus me thinks it's alright, actually. Right, okay, let's reset again, and we'll see what else is on the tape. And there's at least two more games by the looks of things here. I think one could be Finders Keepers, actually. That was a real classic, actually, in my book. One of my favourite ones I bought with my Spectrum money. Spectrum money, my pocket money for my... And I used to basically go on my Spectrum. It was a really good game. I think that could be next, actually. We've done well with this tape. It's not bad, actually. We've done okay. We've had lots of interesting things on there. We've had Joust on there, and we've had Wheelie and Load, Flight Simulator. As I say, I find it really interesting what people thought was worth, copying at the time. And you get your old ghetto blaster out and, you know, stick the two tips in and put the dubbing on. It would, yeah, good.
Right, okay. Nothing yet. It's all very silent.
Still silent. Very silent indeed. Too quiet. Oh, that was I spoke too soon. It was a long pause between this one and that one. Flag.
Oh, do you know what this'll be?
This'll be the racing car game that we all used to play. This is Checkered Flag for sure. Yeah, that's kind of a giveaway, because they used to do the thing about Cyans. They used to do sort of a double flag and flag. I don't understand why, actually. I think you could type it, couldn't you? Because you could type load flag. You know, you could, suppose you could do it in upper and lower case, but everybody used to load, you know, speech box, speech mark. I don't really kind of get why you would do anything else. It's Checkered Flag. I'll wait for the screen to load. Sound of Spectrum. Tape's clicking away. I like Checkered Flags though, because there we go, it is definitely Checkered Flag. I liked it because you had the McFaster special. You see, and I told you about that, the kind of colours. It's actually interesting that you've actually got some red on here. They had this, the McFaster special. Pegasus, I think, was one of them, and the Scion itself. You've got to choose between these three Formula One cars and whiz around the courses. Really quite enjoyed it, actually. There was a real skill involved in it. However, I remember the other thing was it was really interesting in the controls. You had because you were steering with the controls, they tried to give you some kind of analog control over it. So you had a hard steer left, for instance, and a lighter steer left. So you actually had two buttons for left and two buttons for right. So that you would have one way you were kind of really turning and one way you were turning a little lighter. And it was an attempt at the time to achieve analog, because a lot of stuff, well, to be fair, most things were a not a non-analog movement. They were a digital. They were a, you know, on or off, a left or a right, and, you know, an up or a down. But this was kind of one of those games where they made that attempt. However, it was all right. It was all right, but it was a really good game. I still like it to this day because I like how big the car was. You sat in the cockpit of the car, and you drove along, and you sort of, you know, the wheels were spinning on the side, and it was very loud. I mean, you were the only thing on the track, of course, but it was a sort of loud and leery kind of game. But it was really good. But then again, it's one of these games that if I went out and bought a Spectrum bundle right now, I would find that there'd be a copy of Checkered Flag in it. I actually thought it was going to be quite difficult to get hold of a copy when I restarted collecting my Spectrum games again. It wasn't. I think I'm looking at the moment 7 copies of it, not including the one that I'm keeping, that I've got in my sort of duplicates pile. I've got quite a few duplicates at the moment. I did shed a few recently, though. I sent them to a number of people and said that they want some duplicates. So a few people got some duplicates recently. But my duplicates at the moment are really, really, really down to... and it's really weird, actually, what duplicates you get. The Horizons tape, that came with everything. So there must be at least, I don't know how many 48K Spectrums they sold with the Horizons tape. But let's say, if there was a million, there's a million of them out there. So the fact that I've got 8 of them is probably no surprise. What else have I got on there? I'm just looking at this little list of the things above me. Because it's on the shelves high. If you haven't seen my room, have a little look at it. It's on it's on my channel too. I do a little tour of my done-out room. My duplicates sit up high, just above my head. But anyway... I've got a few from the came with the Plus 2s that Amstrad put out, because of course they put out with a bunch of games like they did with their own machines. But yeah, the things like Disco Dan and Punchy, there seems to be loads of these around. I also got Horace Go Skiing. Why did everybody buy Horace Go Skiing? I'm not complaining, it's not a bad game. But Horace Go Skiing, really? Anyway, Horace Goes Skiing. And the only other one that's really not part of that sort of Sinclair range that came with them, bundled with them, that there's another one that was obviously bought by a lot of people, Kickstart 2. Kickstart 2, brilliant game. Absolutely fantastic, sort of a budget game where you ride motorcycles, a bit like ATV Simulator from Codemasters, you were able to randomise and create your own courses, and it was very clever because of that. It was very clever indeed. So anyway, game's loaded. Hello, Brands Hatch. I tell you which one I used to like. I used to like Paul Ricard at the bottom there, because you could do the big long straight after you got along, so you could get up to speed. But anyway. Let's do Brands Hatch. Number of laps, just the one, because I'm feeling wimpy. There you go, the McFaster Special, the Scion Pegasus, and the Ferranti Turbo. It wasn't what I said it was. I think I said it was something else. Anyway, we're going to go with the McFaster Special. It's a great name for a car. Right, I can't remember how you accelerate. How do we accelerate? I'm accelerating, going through the gears. Oh, I'm going to blow up! Oh, that's really bad. Eye for instructions. You need eye for instructions. We'd like... No. Eye for instructions? Oh, no! Killed myself on that. I can't remember the controls for this, if I'm honest. So that's accelerate. Maybe these are left and right. Ah, there we go. Found the left and right. So that's like the weak one, and then there's like the hard one. So it's like four buttons. So you've got that one going around there. So that's the hard one I'm doing now. So that's that. As I said to you before, it's like that kind of hard movement. And then you've got the shorter movement. So we go around the course. Ah, no! And it's quite tough, but it's really good because you've got the big car there. Anyway, yeah, so if you haven't played Checkered Flag, I am utterly amazed, because most people have played Checkered Flag. Right, so we'll set this again. We're up to nearly an hour here. Thank you for staying with me, sticking with it, and we'll see what else is there. Let's see what else is on this tape. So we have, that was Checkered Flag. So that wasn't Finders Keepers. Well, I thought I was going to get Finders Keepers on here. I'm quite, not that I mind. I just thought that's the game that we were going to get on here. So I'll press the play button, and we're going to give it a try. This has been what's on the tape and a half, hasn't it? I think the last one was about an hour long, though, to be honest. Okay, well, I've got a bit of silence here again, so I'm going to guess that they've left a bit of space again between it and the next game that it's going to record. Ah, here we go. Loading. Program loading. Oh, okay. It's gone green, right? We're not going to know until we probably wouldn't know from Program A anyway, but we're not going to know now until it loads. Wow. Okay. I'm quite excited by this one. I think this is going to be an interesting one. Okay, what's this going to be? I don't know. It may be survival, actually. I might be getting myself excited about absolutely nothing, unfortunately. Okay. It's survival. Oh. And according to this tape, that's the last thing that's actually on there. So, Five Ways Development. Yeah, so this is the game I was talking about before. This is one of these true... It was actually one of the early and possibly true... actual survival games of the time. I can't think of anything else off the top of my head which made you go out and drink water and whatever else it is and be various things. So very good. I'm sorry about the noise in the background if you can hear that. That's my little lad's bouncing up and down. His mum, I think, is hoovering the dog. Don't ask. I think she's just giving it a haircut, so it's getting hoovered. Well, you know, if it's had a haircut, might as well give it a clean. These guys really, I mean, if I remember rightly, so it's a weird set of controls. It's the ones, the same sort of things that you got in Exploding Fist, where it was kind of like all the keys round the S, so it basically made a square around it, so you'd have like up left and up right and up down and down right and down left and things like that. So you've got, that's kind of that for your movement as you go around. So, okay. We're just loading. Okay. It's still loading. Oh. Thanks for bearing with me. The thing about what's on the tape is it really is, it's incredibly random. I don't even try these tapes beforehand. It's just literally chuck them in the player and you see it as I see it. So it's one of those things. It's going to be either good or bad. We're either going to hit lucky or we're not at all. So from now on, you can assume that if I don't hit lucky, I'm going to try and find a cover tape where it hasn't got any instructions, because I've got quite a few. I've got like a box full of tapes that are the kind of a mixture of this kind of thing, where it's people just chucked in compilations as part of their bulk sale and on various places, or whether or not they've sort of just chucked in the cover tapes themselves. Ah, here we go. Right, space moves you through. You can tell it's the same people who made Checkered Flag who made this, or similar anyway. So we can be a robin, we can be a lion, we can be a mouse, we can be a fly, we can be a moth. I think we're going to go with the eagle. So we'll press enter to choose our animal. Right, okay. Choose your starting square. I am going to start in you. Oh, no. That's where I want to be. Right, okay. Oh, so that's my keys round there. So the keys round H. Must remember that. Okay, so we've chosen our starting square there. Right, okay. So we've got water and energy. And I can see... I think O is my prayer. And I got to fly towards my prey. There's a bunny. That's me eating some bunny, so that's my energy up. Bunny, you're going to get eaten. No, missed him. It's got the buttons on the screen, actually. And we'll eat a slug. So basically, we're like highest on the food chain, if that makes sense. So we got to eat our way through various things. And flying over the water, and you've got to watch your energy, and the idea of the game is not to die. As the eagle, you don't have to eat a lot. A lot of poor animals get scoffed by the eagle. But you just got to keep your energy up. As a snake, eat the snake. Oh, missed the snake. I'm moving too fast. Snake's moving too fast for me. I think the snakes are a little bit out of my league. Food wise, I missed him. Oh no, I'm gonna run out of energy just trying to eat a snake. I've got it. Wasn't worth it. It was only a slug or something, or a snail. Oh no, you've been poisoned. Oh, I died on something horrible. See, that's it. But I survived 218 days and 16 hours, so that was my entire life as an eagle, and that's it. That's the game. And it seems to have stopped working as well. And that's survival. At the time, I thought that was quite good, actually. I went out of my gateway specifically to buy this because I saw it and I thought, yeah, this is quite interesting. I convinced my parents it was educational, but really, it's just a survival game. It's quite good fun. Right, let's see if there's anything last on this tape, because that was actually the point where it said survival was the kind of last thing that was written on here. But well, let's give it a try and see if there's anything left on here. If we're lucky, we've got the top 40. So let's reset the spectrum. And we're going to go for it. We'll do load, whatever else. I've just typed the wrong thing because I can't see through the... There we go. Right. I'll be surprised if there's anything else on here, but you never know. Okay, we're listening. I do wonder what that ghost game was at the beginning, though. That would have been quite nice to know what that was. We've had a long pause thus far. I mean, it's not a short pause, this one. It's quite a long one. Right. We'll fast forward a bit. We've got silence so far. Silence. Fast forward again. Give it a good fast forward this time.
Nope, still silence. Silence. The sound of silence. No, I think we've got it. I think that's our lot. I think we can actively say that this What's on the Tape Volume 4 is done. Thank you for watching. I've been your host, Real Genetic Demon. Please feel free to like and subscribe. I try to do one of these a week. Usually publish them on a Wednesday, so if you want to see them, they'll be there. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye now.